As an educator and as a rector today and former Minister of Education, I do have a lot of questions related to future of education. And we hope this fifth conference of the World Academy of Art and Science will have at least a small contribution to try to clarify some of these questions. And my first question, which it's unclear for me, again, as a university professor and rector of a university, is what's the meaning of a university today? In fact, this is just to copy and paste the name of a class which I had 20 years ago in George Washington University, when the professor proposed to us to speak about the meaning of a university. And in my mind, immediately, I had the following question, which now I am ashamed of this, but that was in my mind. What kind of discussion is this? We know exactly what a university is. How can we ask again, what is a university? But after the class, I realized my judgment was really superficial. I was coming from Romania, somehow influenced by the way university was seen in Romania during the 80s and early 90s. And I realized, in fact, the university that we have in mind today, and in fact, the university which I run today, it's a university which has the roots in 19th century and is not necessarily the fitted one for 21st or 22nd century. So I'm not saying this in order to deny the current model. Probably the current model will exist for many years or many centuries. But the question is if this model is enough. It's enough in order to reach the objectives that we announced or our politicians announced very proudly, including access and equity to higher education. And also the context changed drastically. The university where I teach today was established after the revolution in Romania in 1990 in order to prepare people in international relations, political science, public administration, a kind of, in fact, École Nationale d'Administration was a kind of model, and later on Kennedy School of Government. So that was a university designed for a specific purpose. But is this appropriate today or will be 20 years by now? For sure, we have to put these questions. And also there are many, many other questions. The mobility of people and mobility of teachers, professors have increased drastically in the last decades. How do we, for example, recognize a student as a student if he or she moves from one place to another? How do we recognize diplomas? What about the financing of education? Who is responsible? What about quality? Who is deciding the content? And also we are discussing, and we have also in our current conference, the topic of sustainable development. How can we claim we are going to reach these objectives in 2030 when many academic programs have nothing about sustainable development today? So is this the university that we want, or is this a university for the What about the differences between not different parts of the world, but different parts of the same country, where in some places you have 16 universities somewhere around 20 kilometers, and in other places you have no university or academic program on an area of 200 kilometers. So is this access and equity? And again, in simple countries, not in sophisticated countries when the differences and the resources are really difficult to share equally among young people. What about digitalization? You said, Federico, I am a young person. When I interact with my kids, I don't have the same feeling, especially when I see the speed they work and use this comparing with the way I use it. Are we speaking in the same technological language? For sure, the future, their future will be 100% a technological and digital future. ours, it's the way it is. All of these are questions, and are questions not necessary for academics or for people working in the Ministry of Education or in the government, but I think they are common questions across the world. When you speak about internationalization, recognition of diploma, when you speak about content, when you speak about reaching some global objectives, that means we have to have some common approaches when we speak about education. The last idea, and I'll conclude in order to let our speakers today in the panel to introduce their ideas, is related to the connection between higher education and the world that we see down. When I say down, meaning primary, secondary education, and the world that we see up. That means after the graduation of our students. How do we really connect with this? Because we cannot have good students without good primary and secondary education. We cannot speak about access and equity in higher education if we don't have very strong access and equity policies at primary and secondary. And our graduates will not succeed in the real world if we don't connect daily with the real world.